Mark Viso is with us from PACT. Mark, welcome. Tell us about PACT. I mean, a lot of people probably don't know what PACT is, and as it turns out, it's a very large organization.
That's right. Yeah, I find myself comfortable saying that PACT is the least known $250 million organization in the world. Yeah, I think one of the reasons is PACT's a very humble organization. Also, what we do is a little bit more complicated than giving out things. So PACT's really driven by three values. All we do is around partnerships, results, and local solutions. And we figure that, you know, the best way to solve poverty for people to have an active voice is to give them the skills and access to resources that they need to do what they need to do anyway, so they can own their future. So we work in building people's capacity, making sure that once they have that capacity, they can use it. So we work in enabling environments, governance structures. And then lastly, since we all live in an economic world, working with the markets and business to make sure that once people have those skills and are able to use them, that they can benefit from them.
Wow, you sound like the UN.
I wish.
Let me ask this. How many countries do you work in?
We work in about 32 countries, and we have offices in about 29 of those 32. One of the things I love about PACT is one of our values, not a strategic option, but a value deep in the core of PACT is partnerships. And so even where we don't have offices and staff, we do great work with others. Since our whole driving motivation is local solutions and partnerships is about partnering with local organizations, local groups, local communities, so that they can be empowered to do what they need to do.
Do the local organizations in whatever country that you're working in, are they able to help you with working with governments? Because you'll have to work with the government, won't you?
Yes, you know, and every country is different, of course. But for example, like a country like South Sudan, the world's newest country, you know, the government is forming there. And a lot of the structures and networks that exist are community-based structures. And so PACT is able to sort of help facilitate that bridging of developing and building capacity of community-based groups so that they can get clean water, so that their children are taken care of, but also government so they can pass the right policies and have the right systems and administrative structures to allow for those efforts that the community is undertaking to work. So PACT has been there for 15, 16 years and able to bridge that gap.
I bet you have to deal with different cultures, don't you?
We do. 32 countries, 32 different cultures.
Of those cultures, are they readily, easily acceptable of a group coming in from the outside and helping them build capacity?
It's a great question. And, you know, I think one of the fundamental challenges in international development is this concept that outsiders will come in and educate you and give you what you need to own your future, and shouldn't people be beholden to that? And PACT just sees it differently. So one of our other values besides partnership is local solutions. We believe the only way people are ever going to sustainably change their life for the better is if it's really built off of local people discovering and then building whatever solution they think would last, that would work in their culture. So PACT sometimes is slow on the uptake when we come in because we spend a lot of time being adaptive, listening, learning. You know, 98% of our staff of 2,700 people are local. And so that deep embeddedness in the local culture, the local traditions, the local way they see the world is slower. It's not as sexy as coming in with a big technological solution, but we find that it has more dignity and as such it lasts. It's wired into the way the culture works.
One of the things you talked about was measuring results. One of the things that people in the nonprofit world sometimes have a difficult time doing. How can you go in and help people measure results of something that may take a long time
right.
to do?
Right. Well, it's a great frustration, right? You know, we all know if you don't measure something, something probably doesn't get done.
Yeah.
And yet the stuff we're trying to measure is the end of something we've had ever since, you know, Adam and Eve came around. Poverty and disenfranchisement, people with no voice, and so a lot of these untangible, messy things with society. And so you can't measure it quarter by quarter, right? And yet if you don't try, you're not going to make much progress. And so we kind of exist in that tension of trying to measure something that is almost impossible to measure and yet still giving it a good whack to do it. Our third value, I'm glad you brought it up, is results. Because if you can partner with people and focus on local solutions, but you don't make their lives measurably better, it really doesn't matter, right? It's self-aggrandizing egotism of what you're doing. And so we, for PACT, as an organization, managementally, we run it off of, we have 13 targets that we measure every quarter for the organization. But then we have six global targets that all of our projects in all 32 countries need to somehow conspire to make a measurable difference in people live a healthier life. People can earn a living with dignity. People can benefit from the natural world around them. And we have targets on those three things. Sometimes we fail, sometimes not as fast as we'd like. And sometimes even the way we measure doesn't make sense, but we keep giving it a try. And you know, we then report. One of the things I like about PACT is the only US operational development agency that has published all of its data through a group called IATI, an International Associate Transparency Initiative. So everything we do, all our financials, all of our targets, all the groups we work with is public. It's published. We have a philosophy that guides us that says the people we serve and people we partner with have a right to know more about us rather than not. And so when you publish everything, you're publishing what you measure, and then people can criticize and people can challenge, and that makes us stronger.
Right here on Rainmakers, we have had so many different people who are working in global development, and there's a single frustration that many of them have, and that is that they feel that they're working in a silo. Your organization, however, seems like it is holistic and comprehensive.
Yeah, you know, it's a good line of inquiry. We call it the integrated approach. And, you know, even in 5 hours, I probably wouldn't be able to explain all that, what that means. But it's this sense that we all live in a interconnected world and that we focus on lots of things at the same time. So, for example, for me and perhaps for you, at the same time, while we're worrying about if we can pay this particular electric bill, we're saving for our kids' education, the future and the present.
Yep.
And so we think if you just focus on health, if you just focus on water, you're doing some good work. But it doesn't help people own their future, which is what we all want for ourselves and our children. Yeah. And so PACT works on developing people's capacity, getting the enabling environment right, engaging in business markets as a foundational approach to make whatever we do last. But then you have to make a difference, things that make sense to people. Your kid can live past five, health. People can feed their family with dignity, livelihoods, that they benefit from nature rather than not, natural resource management. So we try to work in those six areas, and hopefully that gives people what they need to make their own decisions and own their future.
Let's talk about some of the countries that you work in. Tell us about, you talked about the South Sudan. That's, you know, the world's newest country.
Right.
What are some of the challenges there that you may not have had before?
Well, South Sudan's an interesting country. You know, it's had a lot of struggle, a lot of strife for years. There's a sectarian conflict. There's a resource conflict. There's a tribal versus settled conflict. It's a resource, somewhat resource-rich country that they could be agriculturally self-sufficient. So when you build a new country, there's all sorts of things going on. How do you develop civil society? How do you develop the government? How do you do it in concert? So we're dealing with lots of those things. The interesting thing about PACT is that PACT works in these 32 countries, and most of the countries, not necessarily intentionally, are what we call transition countries, countries that are hard. Mm-hmm. South Sudan, just burgeoning on the world scene. Myanmar, we're very large in Myanmar, been there for 17 years. A country that's just opening up. Yeah. You know, we have 1,800 staff there. You know, on the border of Somalia and Kenya. Zimbabwe. Difficult places to do development. Difficult places to work on sustainable solutions rather than Difficult places to live. Difficult governments somehow to understand and to work with. And I think that's because we're focused on local solutions, and you can work in those places if you're focused on local solutions.
So, Mark, what are you? Are you a diplomat? Are you a farmer? Are you a doctor? Or are you all of those things?
Well, I hope we're not all those things, because if you're all those things, you sometimes are nothing. But we like to exist in these dynamic tensions of seemingly unresolvable contradictions, because in those contradictions, we seem to find the pathway forward. And so for PACT, one of our core competencies is we're adaptive. And if you work off of local solutions, you got to be adaptive. Mm. And so we're a little bit of everything. But we try to focus a little bit on things that have to do with people living a healthy life.
Mm. You work in partnerships.
Work in partnerships.
Who are some of your, I don't want to call them most valuable partners, but some of the most reliable partners, let's put it that way.
Well, most important partners are the community-based organizations, local governments, local institutions where we work. Mm-hmm. That's who we serve. That's who we hope through a dynamic partnership we can discover new ways for people to pull themselves out of poverty. And there's 17,000 of those all over the world. And so those are our most important partners. That's what it's all about. But other partners that conspire with us to work in those local areas, Chevron, very important part. Chevron gets it. They understand. Mm-hmm. And Hilton another good partner with us. Motorola, Intel, USAID, the Global Fund. These are some of our partners.
So most of the partners you've talked about, though, are private entities.
Actually, PACT is predominantly funded by development assistance. Official development assistance, United States government, the UK government, the European Commission government. But increasingly, over these last 4 years, people have found it interesting, this integrated approach. It's a little bit more complicated, a little more sophisticated than just giving people things. And so we've been able to attract other folks that can help us do this work.
It sounds like you just defined sustainability.
I hope so. That's the holy grail.
It used to be that sustainability meant the environment. Now it means the economy. So is that now a primary focus, is building a sustainable economic base wherever you go?
I think that's right. You know, we think that sustainability is around people having access to the skills and resources they need, whether it be around environment, which we focus on, or whether it be around health, or whether around earning a dignified living. It's more about capacity. Mm-hmm. To us, that's sustainability, and then you apply it to different areas of the world.
Mark, if we were to come back in 5 years, sit right here, and I ask you this question, how'd you do? What would you say?
I'd say I wouldn't know, but I'd tell you we'd be able to measure it. PACT's deeply committed to measuring things and learning. And hopefully what I'd tell you is we've learned a lot in 5 years, and we're better, and we've got more partners, and we're learning from them, and they're challenging us. What we'd look like, I don't know, but I know that we'd know more than we do now, and we'd be better.
Mark, thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you very much. I enjoyed it. Rainmaker believes we can change.